Today we explore the town of San Lorenzo, on the southeastern quadrant of Puerto Rico. We visit, or we try to visit, the Our Lady of Mercy Parish, the Priscila Flores Theater, and City Hall. Instead, we ended up visiting a beautiful virtual library with wonderful people that went out of their way to make us feel right at home, and a one-of-a-kind waterfall that's actually a combination of seven smaller ones and a Catholic sanctuary that's so high up in the mountains that you feel like you're actually in heaven. All that and more in our unexpected experience in San Lorenzo, Puerto Rico. It was the 8th of May, and the temperature in many parts of Puerto Rico was over 108 degrees Fahrenheit. Yeah, you could feel your skin roasting in the blistering Caribbean sun. The air conditioner on my Pathfinder could hardly keep up, and our clothes were so sweaty that we looked like we had been hosed down. It seems like every year that goes by, the Sahara dust arrives earlier and earlier in Puerto Rico. Don't know what that is? Watch our other video titled, When to Visit Puerto Rico and Why. Getting to San Lorenzo is easy, especially if you're coming from the Isla Verde, Condado, or Old San Juan areas. Just take the Americas Expressway, that's Road 18, the Ponce Toll Road, that's Road 52, State Road 30, and finally State Road 203, better known as Expreso Chayán, and it'll be the town south of Gurabo. Or better yet, punch in the coordinates on screen and you'll get there in a jiffy. We arrived in San Lorenzo at 8:53 in the morning. How do I know? Because that's the time recorded on my iPhone when I took my first picture. We've learned to arrive early to catch the Catholic churches open. For some reason, it's hard to find one open anytime past 10. Well, we struck out. The Our Lady of Mercy Parish was closed. And it's a pity because the exterior of the temple is beautiful, and according to the internet, the original hermit dates back to 1737. So if the outside appearance is any indication, the interior must have been nice as well. Sadly, we tried the administrative office in the rear of the temple, and we were basically driven away. Despite our friendly demeanor, the lady was unpleasant and uncooperative. So we thanked her for all her help and continued on our way. Come to think of it, most of the photos that I've seen of this temple have been of the outside. Maybe that's why. So I took some pictures of the front of the church, some more of the town square that's right in front of it, and told my wife, let's take a walk around town and get the hell out of Dodge. Now here's my question. Aren't churches supposed to be inviting? The fact that every picture that I've seen of this church has been of a closed temple somehow rubs me the wrong way. A few steps northwest of the temple is the Priscila Torres Theater, a recently restored facility honoring one of Puerto Rico's best folkloric singers. That too was closed, although in all fairness, you wouldn't expect the theater to be open at 9 in the morning. So far, we were batting well below average. So we headed northwest along Muñoz Rivera Street. The plan, once again, was to walk around town for a while and head back to the office. If we would have done that, this video would have been a lot shorter. Fortunately, our first stop was at City Hall, or like we Puerto Ricans like to call it, La Alcaldía. San Lorenzo used to be a ward of Caguas called San Miguel del Hato Grande. In 1811, it separated from Caguas, and sometime later, the Alcaldía must have been built. Why sometime later? Well, because I couldn't find the exact date. Or maybe I stopped caring altogether. What I did find out is that the present alcaldía was built in 1938 after the original one burned down. Right behind City Hall, there's another beautiful square dedicated to the mayors of San Lorenzo. One thing that immediately caught my eye was that in over 200 years, San Lorenzo has never had a female mayor. You can't tell by visiting the square. It's just that I looked it up. At City Hall, we were told about a virtual library that's several blocks southwest on the same street. It's the Rafael Marcano Blanco Virtual Library. But don't let the name fool you. It has plenty of paper books too, as well as other learning tools. We continued southwest on Muñoz Rivera until we reached the library. It was already well over 108 degrees, so the air conditioning alone was a welcoming factor. As we entered the building, we met two wonderful ladies who spent well over an hour answering our questions and pointing us in the right direction. I won't mention their names because they didn't authorize me to do so, but they know who they are and will be eternally grateful. As for the library itself, it has everything you could hope for and then some, from computers and audiovisual gear to specialized rooms and custom exhibits. There's one area in particular that caught my eye, dedicated to José Luis González, author of El País de Cuatro Pisos. That's the four-story country. I read his book in college, and it was eye-opening, to say the least. One of the ladies at the library pointed us toward other places in San Lorenzo worth visiting. I had actually heard of two of them, but by the time we got to the library, we were frankly so disappointed that we were ready to give up. Well, she rekindled our interest, and we left the library headed for Los Siete Chorros. Los Siete Chorros is a beautiful waterfall on the outskirts of San Lorenzo that's any landscape photographer's dream. You have seven waterfalls, hence the Siete Chorros, that meld into one beautiful pond below. The waterfall is located up in the mountains on the Amahagua River, a tributary of the Rio Grande de Loíza. And when I say outskirts, I'm talking about 12 to 13 miles along curvy Puerto Rican country roads. So if you choose to visit Los Siete Chorros, expect a drive from around 30 to 40 minutes. When you get there, you'll find a small restaurant in front owned by Don Chu that goes by the name of Los Siete Chorros. In Spanish, Don means Mr. and Chu is short for Jesus. So basically it would be Mr. Jesus, but the locals just call him Don Chu. The falls are in private property, but the owners are gracious enough to let everyone pass. Just ask for Nancy, that's Don Chu's daughter, and you'll be fine. There's a concrete stairway that leads down to the falls and a small dog called Bruno that at first doesn't seem too friendly. But don't worry, he always bites before 8 in the morning, so if you get there after that, you'll be okay. There's a sign at the entrance with 5 simple rules that shouldn't even have to be there. But hey, some people need to be reminded. Of course, that's not you. In any case, here they are. Number 1, parking is free. Number 2, the entrance is free. Number 3, you enter at your own risk. That includes, of course, dealing with Bruno. Number 4, the owners assume no responsibility for you or your car. And finally, number 5, if you bring children, they'll be your responsibility too. Oh, and one last thing. The gate is only open Wednesday through Sunday. Mondays and Tuesdays it's closed. Simple, right? I wasn't there to swim, so I shot my video, several photographs from my landscape collection, and I was soon ready to be on my way. As I was about to leave, I met Lucy, another one of Don Chu's daughters. She asked me if we were visiting Montaña Santa, that's the sacred mountain in the Queen's English. At 3,500 feet above sea level, it's a place where the temperature drops about 10 to 15 degrees. At first, we had given up on the mountain, but Lucy said that she was going there anyway and offered to show us the way. The view from Montaña Santa is well worth the trip, but be advised that the road is a white-knuckle drive if there ever was one, In fact, there's a sector where the grade is close to 45 degrees. So make sure your vehicle is up to it. And if it has an automatic transmission like my Pathfinder does, don't attempt it on the way back, or you'll burn your brakes for sure. Instead, take the flatter option that Lucy showed us along the old panoramic route, connecting with Road 181 due north, then Road 183, and eventually Road 203, and you'll end up back on Road 30. From there, it's back to toll Road 52, then Road 18, and back to the San Juan Metroplex. San Lorenzo is a beautiful town with many interesting things to see, if they would only put their mind to it. The city is clean, and most of the people are friendly and welcoming. And of course, if you're visiting Old San Juan, save yourself the hassle of traditional city tours. They're expensive, and you'll be herded along with people that won't necessarily share your interests. Instead, order the Old San Juan walking tour. It's packed with useful information about the main attractions, as well as every GPS coordinate and 2 hours of exclusive online video. That way, you'll be able to visit before you visit and hit the ground running when you arrive in the old city. See you next time!